Hi, I'm Jason Thibault, CEO and founder of Da Vinci Medical, and the creator of the Superhuman Protocol. Now, what is the Superhuman Protocol? We're taking three of Earth's most important elements, magnetism, oxygen, and light, in that order, to restore order. What we're doing is we're taking Earth's three elements. There are more than that, but Earth's three elements, magnetism, oxygen, and light, in that order, to restore order. Now, how do we do that? Well, we use three different technologies that give you those three elements in magnitude order. So let's look at magnetism first. If we go back thousands and thousands of years ago, in fact, go back 4,000 years, Earth's magnetic field was about 2.5 Gauss. Well, that's 250 microtesla. It's now down to about 40 microtesla, which is about 0.5 Gauss. Now, why is that important? Because as Earthlings, as humans, we walked around barefoot and we were able to pick up the free electrons coming from the ground. And when we do that, it actually charges our red blood cells so that they separate. If red blood cells separate as opposed to clump, they can now all absorb 1 billion molecules of oxygen, uptake nutrients, and carry it to the 11 organ systems. Well, unfortunately, Earth's Gauss has declined and we're wearing shoes and we're completely disconnected. Airplanes, trains, cars, second floor, third floor. We've disconnected from that which helped create and sustain life. So there's a technology called PEMF, pulsed electromagnetic field. PEMF is a way to get back Earth's magnetic field and the appropriate frequencies that talk to your cells. Your cells speak a particular language you don't understand. And these devices can send frequencies back into the body to get those cells back on track. For example, you can charge the cell and get it alkaline. When you charge a cell, it repels one another. For example, negative 25 millivolts on the cell membrane is actually a pH of 7.35. So what we're doing is, in 8 minutes, we're getting back the earthing or grounding effect, which will last for 14 hours. And we simply lay on a body mat, and we can wrap applicators around body parts, and we can actually affect specific areas that need a little bit more power. So this is the window of opportunity where oxygen absorption is at minimum 30% increased. So now we have a window of opportunity to get more oxygen. And now we move into oxygen therapy, also known as EWOT, exercise with oxygen therapy. This is the action of riding a bike or being on a treadmill or an elliptical while you wear a face mask and you exercise for 15 minutes, breathing roughly 90 to 93% oxygen. And during that 15 minutes, you do 3 to 4 sprints, get your heart rate up. What we're doing is we're introducing oxygen under load. So while the partial pressure in the body goes up, we can actually force oxygen to what we call distal hypoxic tissues. So tissues farthest from the heart that might be choking. Let's just say for all intents and purposes, I put a tourniquet on your arm, the arm will start to become inflamed and hurt because it's deprived of blood and oxygen. A lot of our tissues are going through that same thing, and oxygen therapy restores that. Now, a 15-minute session can be equivalent to multiple hyperbaric chamber sessions, just one 15-minute session. So now the blood plasma is enriched with oxygen, You have forced oxygen into microvessels, capillary beds, arterioles, venules. You've actually pushed oxygen right through the cellular wall, okay? Right through the arterial wall. And when oxygen gets pushed through these endothelial linings, it actually can restore the diameter of an artery back to normal, where it normally is compromised and is narrowed, impeding blood flow. So now that we've oxygenated the body, we've alkalized it doing PEMF, we're now ready for what we call red light therapy. Red light therapy, also known as photobiomodulation, is the act of exposing your body to very specific wavelengths of light. And for the last 30 years, it's been scientifically proven without a shadow of a doubt, and there are more studies than you actually have time to review, that when light is absorbed by the cells, the free radical dominance dissipates. In other words, the bad guys are kicked out of the cell. Think about a home. At night, you've got burglars robbing the house. But if you turn on the floodlights, the burglars go running for the hills. Well, those burglars are called mitochondrial nitric oxide. And when they run for the hills, they actually run into the artery wall. And that helps to vasodilate and relax those arteries. And that's where we get the improved blood flow. But what's really happening is we're kicking the bad guy out of the house so oxygen can come back in and make ATP, adenosine triphosphate. That's our energy chemical. We can't survive without that. We can't have an immune system without it. We can't heal or restore without ATP production. And most people have extremely low ATP production. Now, these three technologies are what I call stacked. That means we do one after another after another, and each potentiates the next. So let's look at, again, PEMF therapy. We're laying on the body mat, alkalizing the blood, separating red blood cells so they can all absorb more oxygen and nutrients better than before. Carry it to the 11 organ systems. Now the body says, thank you. I can restore order. Now the body is ready for oxygen therapy. Because you've just separated the cells, now we can get a billion molecules of oxygen to every red blood cell. So now we do our oxygen therapy and we exercise for 15 minutes. Keep in mind, bacteria and viruses can't survive in high doses of O2. They're anaerobic. Once you've surpassed O2 absorption at the cellular level, you have additional oxygen dissolved into tissues, deep tissues. This is the best time now to do red light therapy. Now keep in mind, when a photon or light hits a cell, it wants to hit a cell that's not stuck to another cell. We get more surface space for more light absorption. And then when the disassociation of mitochondrial nitric oxide from cytochrome C oxidase occurs, we can get oxygen back in to make ATP. Again, fancy way of saying, when we turn the floodlights on at the house, the burglars go running out, the good guys come running in to save the day. So light is put on steroids because oxygen has to come in. We just did oxygen therapy. We just separated all the cells by doing PEMF therapy. So PEMF plus oxygen plus light in this order creates a protocol of magnitude order to restore order. It doesn't matter if you're a professional athlete, this can help you train harder and longer in the gym. You'll have greater endurance and stamina to get through an even more effective workout. You'll accelerate your recovery. Delayed onset muscle soreness will be less. If you're somebody with particular medical condition, you may see a reduction in discomfort. You may notice some of your symptoms dissipate. Followed by a good diet and nutritional advice, the superhuman protocol can take almost anybody and get them back on track. Remember, we're taking three of Earth's most important elements, magnetism, oxygen and light, in magnitude order, in the right order, to restore order.